Hey everyone, we are back in the kitchen for another episode of Southern Cooks. Today we are making a no-bake chocolate cake with Margaret, Eileen, and Sylvia all the way from Newcastle, England. All right guys, let's take it away. And this is Margaret who is going to be starting us off, right? All right. And what are you doing? I'm gonna come around on the other side so I can see you measuring. And these are just plain animal crackers, right?
Yes. What brings you ladies here from Newcastle?
My son and his wife. And a holiday.
When do you bake this? I know it's a no bake, so what time of year do you usually make something like this?
Usually Margaret makes these if we'll have a get together. Margaret, our adult woman, makes them.
Oh, okay.
Just any old time you guys get together?
And just eating a second.
You're measuring this very precisely. It's making me nervous.
Well, back in England, it would be much too distant.
Okay.
This is probably the equivalent here.
Okay.
The nearest good friend is in the
Is that it?
So how much? Mm-hmm. How much of that do we have then?
It's 300 grams.
300 grams. And what are you doing over there?
I'm just putting the pan up to help me to smoke the butter.
Alright, tell us how much butter we are using.
4 inches.
How much, I'm sorry?
One
stick.
Yes.
And then we're using one of the small cans of sweetened condensed milk.
And just mixing them in the bowl together.
150 grams of chocolate.
150 grams of chocolate is our next step. She's still very precisely measuring over there.
Down to the cookie.
Mm-hmm. You have another bowl, please.
Oh, yes.
We're going to crush them all up.
And that's a neat way to do it so you don't get crumbs everywhere, too. Clean up a big mess, put them in the Ziploc bag.
It's something to make this.
Oh, yeah.
Good deal.
Now we're going to measure the chocolate, 150 grams, is that what you meant?
Can you move it?
And how fine are you going to match those, Sylvie?
These ones will be quite fine, but they'll keep some back in the market, just maybe a quarter inch size.
About like that.
So if I grab one out of the bowl, would she have to remeasure them all?
Probably.
Really? Why don't you say hi to Emily?
I wouldn't, but
she's watching.
Say hi to Emily.
Hi, Emily.
And Paula. And
I bet you wish you weren't here.
Hi, Natalie. Hi, Paula.
We miss you, Emily. I see that.
Yes.
It really makes me want to grab one of those cookies out of that bowl.
And this is just some regular old Hershey's milk chocolate.
And we're going to melt this, is that what you said?
Yes.
Okay. So kind of using our pot with the water, a double boiler?
Yes.
And you have to keep stirring it so it doesn't catch on the bottom.
Is this something you guys usually do together, or does one of you just make it, or? Okay.
Margaret, all right.
Well, she does the cooking, we do the eating.
Oh. It's a good trade.
Lots hanging on top.
And this is the one stick of butter, one can of sweetened condensed milk, and then the chocolate.
Yes. And just keep stirring it so it doesn't stick.
That that tastes delicious.
Ooh. If we had to wait for my sister to cook, we'd wait till Thanksgiving. Who's the oldest? But you're the lead cook over there. It usually falls to the oldest sibling.
I don't cook. I make cakes, but you don't have to cook it.
You make the cakes, so you don't have to cook it. That's smart.
Yesterday we had lucky lime cheesecake.
And we didn't get the leftovers from that?
No leftovers. Not to say anything.
Miss Paula says hi.
Hi, Paula.
Natalie says, good evening, ma'am, Auntie Sylvie and Auntie Margaret. Hope you all are behaving.
We are being as good as old Natalie.
Not a bit of a
bother. Oh, and she said, have you put the kettle on? And Lucas sends a big kiss.
Yeah,
we need another bag. All about crushing these.
Yeah, these cakes are everything.
I see that. Maybe a meat mallet? If we had one.
A smoky gap in there.
Yeah, they're very fine.
Yeah.
But it's a lot easier than doing them on this and then having to clean all that mess up.
Yeah.
You want to?
Yeah. It's all good.
I think I've got the easiest.
Oh, yeah, yours has to be constantly stirred. Nearly this quiet Friday when I saw you. At all.
I'm best behaved for people.
You've been warned.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Well, I'm going to be grounded if we're naughty.
I'm not scared.
She's watching it.
Susan is watching.
Oh my God.
When the camera comes back, say hi to her.
So when Emily came the last time, remind me what we made. Because your granddaughter Emily came.
We made Devon cream scones and cheese scones, and then we did millionaire shortbread.
Yes, millionaire shortbread. That was very, very good. Mm-hmm. And I can tell you, the vultures are out there circling. I call them the fleas that work for me. Because they know that chocolate and these cookies are involved. We just sent them all back to work. They wanted to stay in here. We'll bring them in when it's done and let them sample. I think Mary may have already had a sample.
The cookie rice.
Mm-hmm.
With just some tea.
I think she said the plate wasn't evenly balanced, so she had to make sure.
She was just evening it up.
Sue's watching my bed.
Sue's watching to say hello.
Hello, daughter.
One of them's a bit on the shy side.
That's me.
Oh, yes. Obviously. When you don't cook and you're this precise with crushing crumbs.
Is that starting to melt together yet?
Yes. Just waiting for the chocolate to melt.
It sure does smell sweet and delicious over here.
Andy's over there telling you not to forget things. We told him that.
Here's the peanut gallery for anybody who wants to see.
And we should say we miss you, Miss Charm, because you were supposed to be here too. So, at least now we know there
will be things left to ask. Yes. Because Miss Charm is in here.
There will be leftovers.
There'll be much left over from these.
There won't be much left over from these. There never normally is. And there'll be a mix.
We don't think you guys have had the joy of meeting Miss Charm yet, though. She would have brought her Tupperware with her.
All right.
So there definitely would have been no leftovers.
It's getting there.
Just about.
That chocolate certain amount. Oh, Natalie says Eileen is anything but shy.
That's right. I'm the youngest of them all, so.
You have the beauty of being the fun one.
I'll have to stick up for myself. The youngest of 10.
Of 10?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
I didn't know that either.
Wow. So there's the three of y'all. Who else?
Oh, we've got the six sisters all together.
Six sisters all together. Wow.
Yeah. And three brothers.
And three brothers, wow.
That's a lot of women in one house.
But it was fun growing up together.
Oh, yes.
It was different. That's what she said. It was different.
Yes. We're not all the same nature. We'll just put it that way.
Now, are we doing some of these different sizes, you said? Yeah. Someone
would just,
like,
grow
in a corner or something?
It's coming together now.
Sylvia said, even with all those children, they're very lucky that they only ended up with one cabbage in the family.
And that's me.
And that's Eileen. Special.
I don't know what that means. Oh, okay.
And then breaking these remaining cookies into other pieces to give it crunch.
Okay.
So some of them are real fine, and some of them are going to be in pieces.
A bit bigger.
That's probably about a cup or so of cookies that she's doing in pieces.
Yeah.
Oh, nice.
Can't do the grains. I like them when they have the reader. Not like
that. I'm going to check this.
Now, is this a recipe that Margaret created?
No, it's a proper recipe, but this is just in my head now. I think it was everyone knows.
Oh,
okay.
So you found the recipe in an old book?
She got it all fixed up for you?
Yeah. So got it a bit lumpy.
Okay. I think one of our very first episodes of Southern Cooks, we did a pound cake with Miss
Carla.
Yeah.
No, not that one, the other one. Mr. Dasher's wife. And it was a
coconut cream.
Coconut cream, that's right. It was a Southern Living recipe, a very old. She took a copy of the magazine.
Oh, nice.
And it was in tatters. Also really good. We like dessert.
Yeah.
So you're just peanut gallery.
Exactly. Just have to add some commentary.
What is Emily doing now?
Emily is getting ready to be moving to school in July.
You're getting old.
Yeah.
Emily says hello, by the way.
We said hello to Emily.
Okay.
Sorry. Emily wanted to be here this time.
Maybe she can come next time.
Just like she wanted to be with us.
Yeah. We always welcome people who want to cook for us. So what are we going to do after we get all these crumbs?
Mark it, we'll mix it all into
what kind of Eileen's mountain. Mm-hmm. And put it in the milk and in the fridge. Well,
okay. And I heard white chocolate was involved somewhere.
Just to decorate the top.
Oh.
Well, not just to decorate the top. It's going to decorate the top. It's best overnight in the fridge.
And by the miracle of TV magic, we will pull one out.
One?
So that means we have two.
Three.
Three? I thought I said three.
Are you steady?
Yeah.
they're almost done, and your chocolate looks like it's perfectly melted.
Chocolate's done.
I could just take that bowl right there and eat it with that spoon. I don't need the graham crackers or the...
Don't tempt her.
There has to be some for everybody.
The last time I had this, I was 21st birthday.
The last time you had this?
At Monty Barbara did.
Ah. So that was, like 5 years ago?
How many years ago was that?
30.
Two years ago. 30 years ago. 26 years.
Jesus.
34
years.
Oh, wow.
I've
And you've probably done it enough now, you know what exactly does work and what doesn't work. Which is why you're so precise. Right.
We did the whole thing.
Yeah.
But I do want it.
Oh.
We did do the proper biscuits, but you wanted them.
You stole our biscuits. That's what I heard.
English biscuits.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Last of the animal crackers going in.
Now you can see some of them are being redone because I'm thinking they didn't meet Margaret's criteria for being done. So she's fixing them for you.
Yeah.
It's a sister thing.
She knows how it's supposed to be.
Mm-hmm.
We still need this.
We
still need this.
We don't mind.
Happy to put this on.
You can put it on the counter. Yep. Do you want hot water though?
So we're going to mix these graham crackers, or these animal crackers, excuse me, into the chocolate.
Yes.
Okay.
Do you want a spoon? This one?
Oh, yeah.
They're getting it off the stove right now.
Okay.
Please be careful with the bowl of chocolate.
It's a very hot bowl.
Our precious bowl. So we've got 300 grams of crushed animal crackers. I do not know how many cups that is. I will do the math for you guys later. And then 150 grams of milk chocolate and one can of sweetened condensed milk and one stick of butter. All get mixed together. Look at that teamwork.
Oh, now she's gonna have to remeasure. You're in trouble.
Well, I'll just let you do it. Sorry.
No, it's all right. The ball was sliding.
Oh, it was slipping.
The ball was sliding about that was all.
So what is y'all's favorite thing that each other makes?
So there's corned beef pie,
minced
curry pie.
I like corned beef.
And mine's a cup of tea.
Every other week. Easily.
You're good girls.
Yeah, Ailey makes jam.
Oh.
That's a good thing, too.
Which is nice to go on the Devon scones.
Yes.
Why? We never tried your jams.
You'd have to wait until they come over.
You'll have to wait until come.
We got plenty of time now.
Yeah.
And fruit is in season.
Oh, yeah. Blueberries are about to come in soon.
What?
Is raspberries cheap?
No, not cheap.
What
about blueberries?
Yeah, we do.
Well, and, I mean, you think about the conversion, so it's very cheap.
And figs. Figs are right now. They're not ripe yet. Fig jam is awesome.
I make, seedless raspberry jam.
Yum.
Blackberry jelly.
I know where we can get blackberries. I know that. I'll go pick them for you.
Right now.
Yeah, right now. I mean, not literally right now, but yes, there are blackberries in abundance.
Strawberry jam after.
Strawberries are also in season in Georgia.
Your granddaughter loves the blackberry jelly. She kind of get me up.
I'm gonna guess we shouldn't ask the caloric content of this dessert.
Probably not.
Yeah. Now for the pan, are we going to do anything special to it? We have to grease it? Or?
I already did.
Okay, so you did grease it.
I did,
okay.
Yes.
Getting a bicep workout there. Yeah. Bernie Marshall says, good old English granny's cooking.
Who was that?
Erica says, it looks very good.
Oh, it's nice.
They can look at it until it looks good.
It's hard to go wrong with
chocolate, that butter,
yeah.
Sweet cookies.
Cookies, yeah.
Not many calories.
No, none at all.
So we're going to put it in the refrigerator, and it's best to put it in overnight.
Yeah, it's best overnight, and sets before.
Do you do the white chocolate before or after? The drizzle.
Put milk chocolate on first and then drizzle the white chocolate just for a bit of decoration.
Yeah. Oh, Erica says international calories don't count, so we're good.
Oh,
she saved us.
You got to cool down
then. Lillian's going to do the magic of TV for us.
And look, it's cool.
Ta-da! Measuring again. You said 150 grams again?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. I love how y'all have so helpfully stepped to the side.
Yeah, they're poking each other over there. You have to take them out back to the woodshed, which we still have.
Be terrible.
Yeah.
Be terrible. Over there.
She's like, I'm fucking up with hands feathers.
Look at the hands feathers.
Now, we've already had to warn Mary about her colorful sayings. Y'all can't add to them because you wouldn't understand hers.
You know what the sign is?
No.
She's got a few.
Yeah, you can go that way. We told Mary she couldn't say mad as a spray roach, and she likes to do that one a lot.
Right.
So we're just going to pop this chocolate in the microwave?
Yeah,
yes. Does anybody out there in Facebook land have any questions for the ladies or what we've been doing?
Don't eat them too hard.
Declan says, hi, everyone.
Hi, Declan.
Hi, Kate.
Valen made her talk.
Grab them. She has a moment.
Lisa Ann wants to know if we can post your recipe. Silence. You better be writing it down, Lisa.
The full recipe.
The whole video appears, yes.
I mean, the recipe itself.
We usually go back and put it on there. Mm-hmm. Once we do the conversions.
I need some help with
one. Oh, yeah. Do you want help with that one?
We'll need it on for about 20 seconds.
Oh, no. You can have
it. We'll stop it in 20 seconds.
Just so we can get over the.
Yeah.
You guys.
Hello.
Ready to taste? Have y'all already tasted this recipe?
Yeah. 26 years ago.
Oh, okay.
32 years ago, you did. Remember?
Okay, keep going.
Elisa is saying hello from Spain. And Natalie wants to know when Andy is going to do scotch eggs. Which I believe you promised to us before and never did.
Not to make on video.
You could still make them for us.
I could be at them.
Who is this us you speak of?
When you leave?
My last day is June 1st.
Okay, I'll be at them.
I'm panning away from you.
She's wanting it to melt just a little bit, not all the way, because it'll burn, right?
Mm-hmm. Right over there in that top drawer.
To me,
to you.
Well,
you no.
You to behave yourself.
I'm trying.
She's just making sure it doesn't burn by cooking it too fast or too long.
What is this? The microwave dance?
That's the microwave finger, Lillian.
Oh, hello. Cheeky mother.
Yeah, this is so easy. Mr. Dean,
do you want me to start doing the microwave or are you going to measure that? Hot. Oh, so you take it out. Okay. I'm watching and learning.
Well, the bottom of the cracker. Put the chocolate on.
I say that all the time now. I couldn't hear over the pan.
Oh, sorry. No, if you do it on the bottom, it's flat on the surface.
Oh, that's smart. Very smart.
Yeah, we can just put the chocolate on.
Okay.
It's useless. Oh.
What about a fork?
Spread it.
Oh, the spatula.
What do you want today? Today?
Anything. I've got to go in with that.
Do you want a hot water?
I'll be quick with this bit because it starts to set before you read. Oh, that'll do. Mm-hmm. Starts to set before you go to do.
Mm-hmm. You're saying you gotta work fast because it'll start to set before you get done. Because if it's really cold and the chocolate's really hot, it's gonna harden it.
It smells delicious.
It does. It smells very good. None for you.
I'm just gonna put it on the top. I'm not even attempting to phase.
We don't care. It's chocolate.
Lisa says no oil or cream. It's just straight Hershey's chocolate.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
There's okay. Yes. Just straight chocolate.
You should do it down the sides, but I could never do that pretty good. So we just put it on it.
It's a very generous layer of chocolate.
Mm-hmm.
You're
not a stingy.
No calories. No calories. International calories don't count. So says Erica. Who probably weighs 110 pounds soaking wet.
This
so.
Is the Erica who's going to be eating crunchy balls right now. Is that the Erica who's going to be eating crunchy balls right now?
The one who's eating them currently, yes.
Sophie says, hope my grandma and my two favorite aunties make this for me soon. I feel very special now.
Set a bit before you put the water.
Okay. That sounds like you have been enlisted to cook again when you get home.
So she said we'd let this sit.
Roots in our coffee.
Oh, can you use the scale again? I'm in the way. How much white chocolate are we going to do?
Just no way, just a little bit.
A little bit?
To melt, just to drizzle.
It would probably give you a heart attack to see me cook.
Okay. About a handful?
Yeah,
about a handful.
So Sophie wants one of these made. That
yes.
Means to get the stuff over, Sophie.
She's
scared.
Sophie has a new apartment, right?
Pardon?
Sophie has a new apartment.
No, Sophie's back to mom and dad.
Well, perfect, then they all went.
So she's melted the chocolate. It's 150 grams again?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Okay. And very quickly put it on that because it was cold. And it will set the... Oops, so sorry. I forget my dog. I was supposed to be doing that. I forgot.
Thank you.
You're so welcome. We've melted the 150 grams of chocolate onto the pop cake.
Yes.
Almost cut it a pie again.
And I was down well back.
And you stand well back? Oh, okay.
Sophie says she can't wait for sleepovers with cheeky oldies.
Brilliant.
I love scandal.
No. She looks so sweetie.
Especially when she needs to ask the boys her name. Ask her about the hats.
You ask her.
Sophie, what about the hats?
Natalie says, why did she ever stop eating chocolate?
She got hypnotized.
I don't know why you would do that either, Natalie. Sophie says, yes, she does love you really, and your hats. On a pretty plate.
Yes. Just awesome. A reminder, our doors are locked, so you cannot come visit us this afternoon. Babies, want to wrap it up? You want to say any goodbyes?
Bye, everyone.
Bye, everyone. Have a nice day.